Hello, myself P.V.Ekhande, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department of Walchand of Technology, Solapur. Today, we'll have the discussion on single acting reciprocating pump. At the end of this session, students will be able to discuss the working of single acting reciprocating pump. In single acting reciprocating pump, the water is lifted from low level to high level. So as you know, the basically pumps are used for lifting of water from low level to high level. In the same way, the single acting reciprocating pump is used for lifting of water from low level to high level. For this purpose, the arrangement is similar to the piston and cylinder, which is in case of the IC engine. IC engine is provided with the valving system, but in this case the valving system is very simple, in that we require the camshaft, then push rod, then rocker arm. So these are the elements which are required for the working of that valves, opening or the closing of the valves. But in this case the principle is very simple. In this case, when the piston moves in the outward direction, there will be creation of vacuum, and due to vacuum creation, the water from the water sump or the storage tank that rush inside the cylinder portion, and when the piston moves from outward location, that is the outer dead center, towards the inner dead center, there is a closing of this inlet wall and opening of the exit or the delivery valve is there, and due to that then the water rush to the delivery pipe, and through delivery pipe that is collected in the tank, which will be stored at the high level. So in this, the piston is connected with the piston rod, and then piston rod is connected to the connecting rod and the crank mechanism, where the crank is rotated with the help of the electrical motor, which gives the mechanical energy to the reciprocating pump, and this mechanical energy is converted into hydraulic energy, or the energy is given to the water, which pressurizes the water, and then it is sent to the delivery tank. Now the construction wise, in this case the piston is provided with the O-ring, so that there is a closed sealing portion on this side and the water will not rush to the opposite end of this. So this O-ring is provided for the piston ring, piston, as well as the piston rod which will be here, that is also provided with the O-ring, so that the proper sealing is there. The water which is actually sucked inside the cylinder portion during the suction stroke, that is from inner dead center to the outer dead center, so during this water will rush inside this because of the pressure difference. As you know, on this water level the atmospheric pressure is acting, so this atmospheric pressure is higher as compared to the vacuum which is created inside the cylinder portion, and due to this water automatically rushes inside the cylinder portion, and the cylinder will get filled in with the help of the water as it moves in the outward direction. Now when the outermost position is reached by the piston, at that time the connecting rod position will be at the extreme right hand side on the circular portion, so that is on the axis line on the extreme right hand side, and inner dead portion will be on the circle at this location, which is the extreme left hand position for the piston. So when the extreme right hand side is reached, after that the piston movement is in the inward direction towards the inner dead center. So due to the pressure which is acting on the water, this valve will get closed automatically. So this flip type of the valve is provided in such a way that this closes because of the pressure acting on this side, and the pressure of the water opens the delivery valve, and because of that the water goes to the delivery pipe, and then it is collected in the tank portion, collected in the tank or the wherever it is to be carried out. So that is carried with the pressure, and we can have the storage of the water inside the tank portion. In this, one of the disadvantages is that there is a intermittent supply because of the suction of the water during only the stroke from the inner dead center to the outer dead center inside the cylinder, and during this there is no delivery at all to the delivery pipe. So means for the half rotation there is a suction of the water, and for the remaining half rotation there is a discharge of the water. So due to that there is an intermittent supply of the water, and we'll have the discharge rate less as compared to the double acting type of the reciprocating pump. So this problem, that is the intermittent supply, can be overcome by the two methods. One is we can go for the double acting type of the arrangement, and second is we can provide the air vent tank over here. So this air vent tank which is provided on this side, so inside this there will be storage of the water when it is moving to the discharge side, and this tank which is provided for the collection of the water is totally closed one. So when the suction of the water is going on this side and no discharge is going on this side, at that time from this air tank the water rush to the discharge pipeline, and then for the remaining time the water is collected in the tank from the air tank which is vent tank which is provided on this side, and we can have the overcoming of this intermittent supply to some extent. But the best method is to have the double acting type of the reciprocating pump. In the double acting reciprocating pump, what will be the change over here? In that case there is one more line connected at this location, so that, and the one more delivery line is also required for this side, so that whenever the suction is going on this side there will be discharge from this side and then it goes to the tank portion, and when the suction is going on this side the discharge will be on from this side and the discharge will be given to the tank portion. So like this we can overcome that problem by providing the double acting type of the arrangement. In this actually we don't require the footwall which is required for the centrifugal pump. In this the footwall is not necessary because during suction automatically the water rush from this side and then inside this the water will be stored, water will be taken and then discharge will be through this pipe. In case of the centrifugal pump, what happens if the footwall is not provided, at that time the water returns to the well or the tank through the pipeline instead of retaining inside the cylinder portion, inside the casing of that centrifugal pump. But in this case what happens when the there is no movement for the piston, so this suction wall is closed and water inside this remain as it is during the idle condition of this reciprocating pump. And whenever the pump starts there is a motion of the piston in the right hand direction and water will be sucked because of the pressure difference inside this cylinder. So this is the working of the single acting reciprocating pump, which is basically used for the very high pressure application. The discharge may be low as compared to the centrifugal pump, but in this case the pressure developed will be very high as compared to the centrifugal pump. So this is the main application for the residential or the industrial purpose where the high pressure is required. Wherever the high discharge is required, there we can go for the centrifugal pump. So this is regarding the working of reciprocating single acting reciprocating pump, which is required for lifting of the water or carrying the water from one location to the other location, which is in the industrial application or for the agriculture application, or it may be in the residential zone where the water is to be lifted from low level, that is a ground level tank, to the overhead tank which is located at suppose some 5th floor or the 10th floor. We can have the pumping of the water from low level to the high level. Thank you.